Hi, Ron from Clarity. In this video, we'll cover how the Clarity auction platform allows both buyers and sellers to manage their auctions or listings. Here's an auction site that I've set up that is targeted towards high-end jewelry. At least that was the look I was going for with my design. First off, let's check my buyer dashboard to see what I've won lately. Well, looks like I haven't been very lucky lately as I haven't won a single auction. Well, let's rectify that. Here's an auction for a very affordable necklace that's ending soon. As you can see, I'm not listed as the highest bidder, and the place button is active, so let's place a bid. Well, that was easy. Now, let's hope that we've met the reserve, and just to show you, I'll give you a peek into the live auctions view where a minute ago, since I'm also the seller on this item, I actually knew what the reserve was and that we were going to win this auction if I was the highest bidder. Back to the auction, which has been counting down in the background, and voila, we won. Let's not only go look at this newly won auction, let's check out all my buyer auctions, and again, since I'm also a registered seller on the site, all my seller auctions as well. The drop-down menu separates out the shopping links from my account links for convenience. I'll just click on the first link here to view the orders. Once in the dashboard, the navigation menu moves to the left so I can see all of my management areas, which for this video, we're focusing on the My Buyer Auctions area and the My Seller Auctions. Under My Buyer Auctions, the first link is to any auctions that we've won, which at the start of this video was pretty dismal, but it's now proudly displaying our 14-karat rose gold diamond necklace. The View action allows us to check the shipping status as we're excitedly awaiting its arrival. Next on our list are the auctions that we've lost. In this view, we've included the winning bid, the reserve, the number of bids, so we can see how active the bidding was or how far off the reserve we were. Next is the watch list. These are items that we may or may not be bidding on, but we want to track, either out of curiosity or to possibly jump in with a bid if the bidding doesn't get too rich for my blood. You can see that we've also provided the bidding control to allow us to view the buy now price or jump in and place a bid right here. The next area are the listings that I'm currently bidding on. All helpful information like the bid timer, the current bid, the reserve, whether I'm the highest bidder or not, and the ability to either buy it now, if available, or place a bid or here. This is the view that I'll spend most of my time at if I have quite a few auctions I'm bidding on. Now, let's jump down and view our seller dashboard capabilities. The first link takes us to the auctions that successfully sold. That means they were either bought now or a bidder's bid surpassed the listed reserve and was won. Our dashboard view shows the winning bid, the number of bids, and our action is to view the auction where we can see the winner and their contact information so we can ship the item to the buyer. The next link shows our live auctions or those that are listed as we speak and have not yet been bought or bidding ended. The helpful information here is the timer, the current bid, the reserve, and the number of bids. To see how this helps us, let's look at this bracelet I've listed here. Let's pretend that instead of 264 days, 4 hours, and 11 minutes remaining, it was just 11 minutes. I have 3 bids that have been placed, but we're well below our $2,400 reserve at just over $1,450. Our action ability is to edit the auction. So I can come down here, adjust the reserve down to $1,500, save the auction, hoping to ignite a final bidding fury of those possibly 3 bidders, knowing that they're within striking distance to winning the item. For any of you that have ever seen a Meekum or Barrett Jackson auction, you probably remember hearing the auctioneer yelling, "The reserve is off!" with cheers erupting from the crowd, knowing that there's for sure gonna be a winner, and the seller hoping that this ignites a final flurry of bids. Our final area is the ended auctions. These are the auctions that the timer has run out, but the bids did not reach our reserve. The helpful information here is to know the highest bid that was placed, the reserve that wasn't reached, and how many bids were placed. The action, basically the same as above, allows us to either reset the timer and relist, or possibly just lower our reserve, then reset the timer and repost. Maybe we upload newer, better pictures, we adjust the description, any other tricks that we know could possibly help boost the sale for the next time we list the item. If you're the auction house or seller, you may even want to see the emails of all the bidders to reach out and market the item or similar items to them, but that's for another video. So to review, we saw that we'd never won an auction, we went out and bid and won a necklace, we went into our dashboard and walked through our buyer auctions, first looking at our newly won auction area, then moving into our lost auctions, then listings that we're watching but not bidding on, and finally, our ongoing bidding management with our current bids. Next, we moved on to the seller auctions, viewing the auctions that successfully sold, then those that are currently live and running, and ended with those that ended but did not get purchased. So that's a quick demo of some of the capabilities of the Clarity Auction e-commerce's platform ability to allow both buyers and sellers to manage their auction listings. Thanks for watching.